Today we will see multivariable optimization problem with equality constraint. So how to solve and what are the strategies and what is the problem statement that we will discuss. So first the statement of the problem, that is, if some function is given, that means maximize or minimize f of x subject to a constraint. So what are the constraint? Gj x that equal to bj, where j varies from 1 to n. So this j represents the number of equations and x is nothing but the n component vector, that is x1, x2, xn, this one. Okay, that means this suggests that this function we have to optimize, and this function depends on the n variable, n equations. So this is our problem. Now how to solve this? Okay, we have to do, means how to do, how to solve. So one of the basic strategy is that we have to convert this problem to our previous knowledge. That means in our previous knowledge, or what we have to do, what we have done. So the problem is equality constraints, optimization problem with equality constraint, but we know without constraint. So we have to convert this equality constraints to no constraints problem. Okay, so in this problem we have given f of x, g of f of x, gjx, but now by some means if we convert this problem to f of x, okay, only f of x, then we know how to do. By classical method we can solve it. So first we will see the classical method or classical approach, that how to find the multivariable optimization problem with equality constraint. So there are two basic methods. First is direct substitution method. So another is Lagrange multiplier method. So first we'll discuss what is direct substitution method, then we'll solve one problem. So direct substitution method, or simply I will write first one. So here the statement is given, f of x subjected to g of x or gjx equal to bj. So what to do? We have to consider this j equation. This means, that means g1x equal to b1, g2x equal to b2. So there are gm equations. If I write j equal to 1, 2, 3 up to m. Okay, so gm equations, we have gm equations. Now what will happen if m is less than n, then it gives some solution. Okay, but if m greater than n, that time it will give no solution. So it will be applicable only when m is less than n. Then how to use? So we have to consider this g values, then we have to substitute this g value into f, then we have to convert this small f of x, okay, to some new variable, that is f of x. And this problem here, there will be no constraints. Then the usual method that we know, the classical method, we have to apply for new no constraints problem, then we can get the problem. So next we will solve one problem, then the idea will be clear.